So high.
Okay, Brian, we're here at the Millennium Lounge at the Principality Stadium. There's a couple of hundred people behind you and they're still pouring in. What's it like to have a cap presentation of this stature with Wales Rugby League?
That's a step forward, Ian. You know, it's the second time we've done this and it's great gaining momentum. It's a real privilege to be involved in an event like this. And it's growing, which makes us all feel good. You know, we've had a tough year in 2015, very formative year for Wales Rugby League. We've done a lot of work on the national governing bodies, done a lot of work on governance. We've done a lot of work on a number of things, but most importantly, on cultural behaviour. And just seeing all these people turn up today is, you know, evidence really that we are moving in the right direction in terms of culture in Wales Rugby League.
Lads out in the field, we've got 16s, 18s, Dragon Hearts, students, all going to be recognised tonight with their caps and most importantly here with their families. Do you think it's massively important for it to be a family event?
More than anything else, rugby league is a family game, and you know, just looking around the room and seeing grandfathers, it takes me back to when I was a kid, when my grandfather followed me, and if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have come through in rugby. And you know, it's such a pleasure to look around the room and see mothers, brothers, sisters, grandparents, all supporting players. It's a wonderful, wonderful feeling.
And we got someone else being recognised as well, Glyn Turner, who didn't, for a second time, hasn't had his cap from years ago. How has that come about?
Well, because his son contacted me, and I remember Glyn, obviously, because I played against Glyn as a rugby union player, and at Evervale, he was a fabulous player, and also when he went into rugby league, although he's a few years in front of me. But Glyn was an excellent player, and what a privilege again to be able to give Glyn his cap, a player I looked up to as a young man.
1975, I played for Wales and had a great Britain cap in 1975. There were no Welsh caps in those days, so to actually get a Welsh cap means a lot to me. Yes. It's a privilege, really.
And it's the second time it's happened to you, wasn't it? There was a rugby union one you got about 40-odd years later.
Well, I played for Wales in Argentina in 1968, and they didn't give caps against Argentina in those days. Whereas after 1978, wherever Wales played, we got a cap. So they sort of backdated it, I suppose you could say. Quite a few of us, actually, had our caps. When I went off in 75, there was no rugby league at all in Wales. You know, and in fact, people sort of poo-pooed it because he went off and all this sort of thing, you know. Very anti-rugby league, they were, you know. But I've always had an open mind, I've always liked both games, you know, and I like watching Union and League. But if I had to take a pick, I would pick probably a league game to watch rather than Union.
It's 40 years since playing the World Cup for Wales, he eventually got his cap. I'm delighted for it. We obviously must be doing something right because this is an absolutely fantastic turnout. Well, you know, we've been growing slowly and, you know, this is another development in the way we're running our game, you know. And time is right to recognise people. And it showed that we are developing. Well, coming off the back of the European win last year, you know, we obviously growing like a you know, we're obviously heading in the right direction, and we're looking forward to the World Cup now coming up in 2017.
I've helped out with the students, but mainly sort of 7 years playing, coaching with the Dragon Arts, and the last 2 years with Wales under 18.
Is this the kind of thing you'd wish to have seen when you were playing with the Dragon Hearts, you know, every year coming to the Millennium Stadium? And getting a cap?
Yeah, definitely. It's a massive improvement with sort of the presentation side of it. In my sort of earlier years in the Dragon Hearts, where the community game was a little bit stronger, we actually had a really, really good side. I still think they've got a crack inside now, and it's nice to see the community game sort of coming on, and teams, the three teams in the CLS this year, and Bridgend doing so well, and hopefully the Dragon Hearts will keep improving and getting back to where they were. Definitely, I think with the scope setting up the new under 20 side, and the Raiders, Tigers, and the Cougars, and the CLS, you've got that pathway there now. You've got some really good clubs. Cardiff resetting up, Abervalley, Bridgend. They all sort of feed in. You've got the next step then with the three sides I just mentioned. And now we've given the sort of 16 to 20 year olds the opportunity to come with a semi-professional side in the South Wales Scorpions, and then hopefully a full progress on to the first.
The future of the club, is this behind you right now?
Yeah, 100%. It's, we are pushing the club in the right direction. And also we're using sort of like our academy system to bring youngsters through as young as 14 to start, looking to start the embedded pathway and getting into schools and creating rugby league in Wales and getting on a bigger scale. So there's a natural pathway from 14 all the way through to hopefully becoming a professional player and representing the country. We have got some players within our current squad that could possibly make it this year, but definitely for the next World Cup, we will be pushing our players extremely hard, especially from the academy, which are obviously some of these players sat behind me, will be hopefully knocking on the door for that World Cup slot